Well, here it is. It just showed up. The Motorola ARRIS model SB6141 400 series cable modem with 8x faster speeds. Here's the back of the box, and they have this handy little guide here. And like the one I was thinking about getting, the SB6121 only has four channel DOCSIS 3.0. And it says up to 172 megahertz. This one has 8 channel, and it says up to 348 megabits per second. And they also have one, looks like must be 12 or 16, although I didn't bother getting that one, but I wanted to future-proof a little. Even the one, the cheaper model would have been enough, but I go, oh, what the hell, it's only an extra $10 or $12. I might as well get the better one. Maybe I'll get better performance out of it because it's newer. This is the first unboxing. Supposedly this was used. I was on Amazon. They had the regular prices, and they go, hey, we got a bunch of them used. But this is one supposedly used, which I really don't think is used. And you can kind of take a look at it. I mean, everything looks brand new in the box. And I saved $20 on it by getting a used one. But it's fulfilled by Amazon, so it had all the Amazon shipping. Everything's got a power bug, all the instructions, and even an Ethernet cable. So like I say, this is supposedly used, but and it was even supposed to, it said, oh, it has some slight damage on it, although, no, it looks perfect. So anyway, just as I thought, you know, buying a used one is really getting a new one and you save $20. It's a nice little look at the front panel. Not a scratch on it, perfect new, and no nothing. The bottom has the MAC address, which you'll need when you go to register this thing. And nothing too exciting on any of the sides. And on the back, it has the F connector for the coax, and a gigabit Ethernet, and a place for the power. And that's about all there is. Let's hook this. I'm going to call up my cable company, give my MAC address, get this thing activated, then we'll get to see it in action. Okay, here's the power supply. This appears really, really cheap. Made by some company, says LTE, and appears to be 12 volts, 750 milliamps. So I don't know. It's as long as it works, I guess it doesn't matter if it's cheap. Here we are. It's all working right now. And as you can see, there's a faint green power light at the top, two solid lights, and a blinking light at the bottom. And this thing is all up and going. I opened up a web browser and typed in 192.168.100.1 and pressed enter, and it brought me to this page. And basically it says everything is done and operational. And take a look on the signal here. And so anyway, here you can see this is awesome. I got all 8 channels. Well, now I wished I got the one that had 16 channels. But, no, I'm actually kind of joking, but, I mean, like I say, 4 channels would have been enough. 8 channels is awesome, and I seem to be getting 38 dB, maybe some 37 dB on one of the channels, so this is awesome. And then the upstream channels, the power level is 51 dBmV, which is a nice, strong signal. Certainly when I was getting the old modem. Of course, my old modem only had one channel up and one channel down, and it was capped at speeds of almost 30 megabits per second. When I do a speed test, I'd even get less. I'd even be getting like 15 or 20 megabits per second and 5 up, but 15 or 20 down. So now I'm going to do a speed test with this brand new modem, and we'll see what happens. Okay, the speed test is starting, and I'm getting 62 megabits down. It was actually even higher. Now it's actually slowing down to 60 and 61. Oh my gosh, this thing's a speed demon. And I should be getting 5 up like I did before. I don't think there would be any difference there. Oops, what the heck? Hey, would you see that thing jump up? Okay, well, there it is. It's like this, what they call speed boost, and it gives you a little boost. But actually, I'm even doing better anyways before. I'm getting like 7 up. Well, this is impressive. The new modem has really kicked some butt here. Different speed test. And this is a speakeasy net speed test, and says I'm doing 63, 62. Man, that's nice, because I'm supposed to be having a 50 megabit connection, and And I guess I'm getting actually more than 50. And, and here's the download. And it's jumping up and giving me some really good numbers. Says I'm getting somewhere around 7 megabit per second down. Very, very nice. I'm getting some really nice speed tests here. So there's the final number. Ooh, now let's see what Comcast has to say. This is the competitor to my cable company. And it's still saying 60, 62, very nice speeds. Everybody seems to be getting really good speeds. And can't complain about 60 when you're only supposed to be getting 50. So 99% done, 100% done. Come on. Okay, well, they said it's 59. And then now we're testing upload speed. Oh my God, that thing shot up to like 25 for a second there. Man, that's a real speedster. That's really, really, really speedy. Well, that's what Comcast says. The AT&T test. Ooh, it's shot up to 62, 63, 64. Oops, or actually, I don't got that in frame, so here you go. Still at a good solid 60. Well, 59. Okay, I guess that they gave the final answer as being just about 59. Now we can see the upload speed. And like I say, this is the AT&T internet speed test. And test is just about done. There's the final number. So I don't know what that's supposed to mean. Well, this is really fast.